Hi folks, CodeTutor here, and my name is Anil Deshpande. This is a continuation of the previous video. In this video, we will continue to explore more about composables. For example, if I add another button here, I don't see two buttons. Let me run this, and you can see that these buttons are on one top of one another. Let me call it as click me one and click me two. These buttons are not there. It looks like as if there is only one button. The reason why this is happening is this one is on top of button one. So how do we improve it? Let's do that. Let me cut this and let me add it under a row. And then this row has a lot of other attributes that you can pass. It has a modifier, it has a horizontal arrangement, it has a vertical arrangement. So what you used to do in the XML, now we are doing it through the Kotlin code. So let me go back here. I will write vertical alignment, alignment center vertically. And under that, whatever the buttons that I had, let me paste them. So now this looks much better. So now you have two buttons, click me one and click me two. And let me stop and run this particular application. But I don't want these buttons to be here aligned at the top. If you go here in the row, the default value is arrangement start. That is, this is the starting position and alignment top. This is the top position. I don't want it to be there. So if I go back, horizontal arrangement, arrangement center end start space around space between space evenly. If I put it as center and check this, it's not looking very clear because this row item is only of this width. We actually want to have a whole screen, and in that particular screen I want to basically see how much space is this particular row is occupying. What I will do is I have this thing called as column, and this column I can make it go modifier dot fill maximum width, and under this I will add this row. Or instead of using fill maximum width, fill max size, so it basically occupies the whole screen. Otherwise it will only occupy the width. So now if I do this, this looks much better, but still these things are arranged at the top. So how do we modify that? So what we can do is fill max size and then vertical alignment, alignment dot center, not alignment, sorry, arrangement center, and then horizontal alignment, alignment center horizontally. If I do that, now this thing actually comes at the center. So what we have done is we have created a column and then vertical alignment center. So anything that is inside it vertically is in the center. If I can change this, start, once again, mismatch. Required is arrangement vertical, but what you found was arrangement horizontal. So you can only write, say, top. This will make this thing go to the top, or bottom, which will make the row that is present inside the column shift to the bottom. Or you can write center, which will make it come at the center. And then horizontal alignment, you can write start, which will make it come to the left, extreme left of the screen, and alignment end, which will make it extremely go right of the screen. But once again, we don't want that. We want it to be at the center. So both horizontally and vertically at the center. And now what you see here is that both of these buttons are, they are very near by one another. To some extent, we can solve this. What we can do is we can provide some padding to both of these buttons. So how do I do that? Since even button is a composable, onClick is first parameter, but it also has a modifier. So modifier dot padding, and you can decide to give a padding of 5.dp, that is density independent pixel. And I can do pretty much same here as well. That will give padding of 5dp, but I'm still not happy. I want these buttons to be exactly evenly spaced out. So in that case,
what we can do is go to the row and say modifier fill maximum width. So now you have maximum width being taken, but still I want some padding of say 2 dp so that it is not exactly attached to the extreme screen side. And then I want these two buttons to be properly spaced out. So let me see, horizontal arrangement space evenly. And if I do that, this looks much better. There are a lot of options here. Dot, start, space evenly, space by, space center, space around. So if I click on space around, the arrangement is slightly different. So I suggest that you spend some time in going through these things. And then under this, I want to add text view. That is, text initial value would be 0. And instead of space around, I want to add space evenly. And sometimes your preview, if it doesn't load immediately, what you can do is come here, click on this up to date and click on build to refresh. And that should automatically render this preview fine. And you can observe that when I select a particular view here in the preview, it directly shows the appropriate code on the left hand side. If I click on the button one, it shows that one, then the text, and then another button. And this button is decrement and this button is increment. And with this, we have a basic screen that we wanted to build. So in this video, we basically understood how to get started with the screen implementation using the Composable, how to preview it. And then we started adding small components like button. We tried to add multiple buttons. They were overlapping on one another. We solved that by adding them under a row. We went through what are the possible values that you can pass to the row, like vertical alignment, modifier, horizontal arrangement. And in the same way, we even improved it much further by using a column. And more often than not, you will also see that people use surface and then add column under that particular surface. We will look that and much more in the next upcoming videos. So stay tuned. That brings us to the end of this particular video. Don't forget to like, comment, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Take care. Bye.